actually see a tube with no bony anything inside.
So the one that has no bony ear tube might still look cylindrical, but there's a bone behind it.
But there's a bone behind it.
And here it looks like all messed up, like it's all just wet, jaggedy lines. And
same here, I don't see any bone inside. I see, it looks tubular to me.
See this one, see this is what's hard to see. Like look at the structure.
Right.
And yeah, but you can see straight through on this one too.
Yeah.
This one goes straight through also. And maybe that's the bony ear too?
And that's one? A strepsirrhine. This is a haplorrhine.
Yes, that's right. But technically,
are the strepsirrhines? So I'm looking for that.
Bony ear tube was like one of the determining factors between haplorrhine and strepsirrhine.
Okay.
Worry about that.
So we wouldn't. Okay.
What you need to worry about on that is the molars and the split of the lip.
Yeah.
So you would look here.
You mean lower? This right here?
No. You would look, for example. Do you see how it splits here?
Yeah. Yes.
That's a determining, and this is a continuous upper lip.
Gotcha.
And then the other thing is that
this.
The dental pattern.
So and this here, right here. The cone.
That's right. That's like right. So the catarrhine versus platyrhine is where you're comparing dental patterns.
Right.
Yeah, that's right.
Okay.
I'm still trying to figure it out.